NIDDK launched the Diabetes Prevention Program, or DPP, in 1996 to find ways to halt this epidemic. The evidence we will report today is so clear-cut that we have ended the Diabetes Prevention Program a year ahead of schedule.
Results of the Diabetes Prevention Programs point conclusively to two ways that at-risk populations are able to delay or prevent the development of type 2 diabetes.
So this diabetes prevention program was set up to answer a very simple question. If, for example, you were to treat these individuals with a lifestyle intervention to get them to lose about 5 to 7% of their weight through diet and exercise, would that sufficiently be enough to greatly reduce, compared to just standard instructions, the rate at which people go on to develop diabetes? And we had a third arm to this trial, something called metformin, which is a standard pill that one uses to treat patients once they have a diagnosis. Well, after 3 years, it became clear that the metformin reduced the conversion to diabetes by about 31%, but this lifestyle intervention resulted in about a 58% reduction. And so working with our colleagues in the Aging Institute, we tried to oversample for people who are 60 or older at the time of randomization. And the reason, as it turns out in hindsight, that that was a good thing, that while overall population, about 58% of the people responded to the lifestyle, if you look only at the people who were 60 or older at the time that they were randomized, they had a 71% reduction in the rate of transformation to diabetes. Medicaid and Medicare services, or CMS, looked at this and said, you know, maybe we should offer this as a benefit for people 65 or older. And just last year, it became an approved benefit. So anyone who's 65 or older can go in to be tested. If they have prediabetes, then they would cover this counseling service to get them. It's very unusual to actually have a clinical trial result in a relatively short order, about 15 years, to actually make this a policy. That's one of the things I guess I'm most proud of.